Hello, fifth graders. We are going to try something new today with a different style of recording. I'm going to be down here in this little bubble throughout the video, so you'll have to just listen and you don't have to look at me if you don't want to. So today, we are going to start a new unit. We're starting unit 4, and it's all about Earth, the moon, and the stars. It's pretty cool. I'm excited about it. I want you to just watch the video of me. I'm going to even do some of the work for you in on the screen. Then at the end of the video, I'm going to have you log in to your Teach TCI and complete a couple of the assignments in there. So pay attention to what needs to be done after the end of the video. To log into Teach TCI, you need to first log into your My Bethel portal. When you log in, you come to your favorites page over here. If you have Teach TCI, select it there. If not, you can select it from this four squares window pane. Find it on this list all the way down here. Once you select it, make sure you let it load. So this is what yours should have opened to. Go over here to assignments. And open it up and select the assignment right here. Mine will not let me put an assignment in there, so I can't show that to you. When you open your assignment, it should open to the investigation page. We are on lesson one of unit four. What does gravity do? We will be opening each of these tabs and walking through this investigation together. To begin the investigation, we are going to observe the phenomenon. What happens when you toss a ball into the air? How do you know what will happen? No matter where you jump on Earth, you will land on the ground. What questions do you have about this phenomenon? Think about what you already know about why objects fall toward the Earth's surface. Most of you already know about gravity and understand the concept pretty well. Part of learning about science is learning how to explain the science concept. Look at this learning target. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to explain the phenomenon. No matter where you jump on Earth, you will land on the ground. Let's investigate gravity. Everyone stand up. Go ahead, you can stand up. Make sure you're an arm's width away from other kids in your house or things in your house. Now jump as high as you can. Okay, what happened? What is the cause and effect relationship between gravity and your motion? The cause is gravity pulling me back down. It affects me because I can jump up, but then I always come back down. Now, it says to pair up, but you don't have to do that. I am going to show you a couple things. Well, I'm going to find two objects around my room, and you can go find two objects. Try to find two objects that are different sizes, or shapes, or weights, but are not easily breakable because we are going to drop them. Okay, go ahead and pause the video and go do that. Do you have your two objects? Okay, so I found my dog's chew toy ball, and I also found a piece of paper. I'm going to hold the object like this. You hold your object up, and when I get to three, drop it. Ready? One, two, three. What happened to your object? Mine fell and hit the table. It came down and hit the table. Okay, now how about your second object? Let's drop them together. One, two, three, drop it. What happened with your object? Did it fall to the table? My paper floated like this, but it eventually came back down to the table. I am going to go ahead and write my observations. Now, sometimes when it says write down your observations, you might want to think, duh, it fell down, Mrs. Webb. Here is a chance to practice writing explanations. Be specific, add details. What direction did it fall? How did it fall? My ball fell straight down and landed on the table. My paper floated back and forth as it fell down and landed on the table. The next section is questioning gravity. In this section, we are going to write a claim evidence reasoning statement to answer the question, what does gravity do? Remember, the claim is just the answer to the question. Think for a moment. How would you answer the question, what does gravity do? It seems like a simple question. I'd love to hear your responses. But since I can't hear your responses, I'm going to go ahead and type my response here. My answer to the question, what does gravity do, is gravity pulls things down to the ground. Evidence. Well, I know that when I jump in the air, I come back down to the ground. And I know that when I drop a ball, it comes down. Those are two pieces of evidence that shows that gravity is pulling things down. And now I'm going to explain it a little bit further. How would you explain how this evidence supports the claim? This is how I would explain it. When I jumped into the air, gravity pulled me back down to the ground. And when I dropped the ball, gravity pulled it back toward the ground. I talked about both pieces of evidence, but I feel like I need to add one more explanation. If gravity wasn't pulling things down to the ground, they would keep floating up or stay in the air. For now, let's take a look at the next section, analyzing, modeling, and applying gravitational direction. Let's examine more evidence to see if we can improve our claim back about what gravity does. Let's observe these objects. We see the raspberries are falling down into the container. Now I know they're falling down because I know that gravity is pulling them down and they're not floating up. I see the drip. The drip is falling down because of gravity. The sugar cubes are falling down into the cup of coffee. The ball is falling down to the ground. And the leaves are floating down. These observations support our claim that gravity pulls things down. But what if we looked at it like this? Let's imagine that all of these objects are on different places on the Earth, in different countries. Let's take another look at which direction they are falling. Remember, we said that gravity pulls things down. Take a look at this object. This object is falling down. Is this drip falling down? It's not really falling down. What about this sugar cube? Now this sugar cube, is it falling down? Or the leaf? Or what about the raspberries? Now let's take a look at these people. We're going to place them in the square so that their feet are facing the earth. And I want you to be thinking about why are they not falling off the earth? If they're standing upside down. You can go ahead and cheer me on while I'm putting these people in the proper place. Yeah! Say, Mrs. Webb, that's the wrong place. Yeah! What do you think? Why aren't these people falling off the earth? Can we say that gravity is pulling them down? Let's put these arrows in the diagram to show which direction gravity is pulling each person. Which direction are these arrows pointing? Can we say they're all pointing down? Where are they all pointing? They're pointing to the center of the Earth. We might need to revise our claim. Let's go ahead and go to this section, revising your argument. Our original claim was that gravity pulls things down to the ground. Based on the observations that we've just made, let's modify our claim. Before we said that gravity pulls things down to the earth, we know now that it doesn't pull things down, it pulls things towards the center of the earth. What observations did we use to revise this claim? We observed that in different parts of the country, down is towards the center of the Earth. I'm going to assign the last four sections for you to complete on your own. Don't stop watching, though. I am going to walk through the expectations of each section so that you know exactly what to do. To wrap up, I'm going to have you think about some concepts that we've talked about and learned about during this investigation and have you reflect on how well you are understanding those concepts. You're going to take a look at the concepts here and reflect on how well you understand each concept. Let's take a look at them.
When a ball is released in the air, it falls to the ground. The force of gravity pulls objects on or near Earth's surface down toward the center of the Earth. How well do you understand that gravity is pulling things toward the center of the Earth?
You're going to drag the dot to show your level of understanding. Expert, understand, or still learning. I can't imagine after watching this whole video that you could select don't know.
All right, here's another one. Scientists identify cause and effect relationships and use them to explain changes and make predictions. They gather evidence by making observations and performing experiments. Scientists use evidence to make claims. When they find new evidence that can be used to disagree with their reasoning, they use it to modify their original claim. How well did you understand that? Does that make sense? How we made our first claim and then we went back and we revised it because we learned something new? Do you understand that's how scientists work?
Drag the dot to show your level of understanding.
Alrighty, here we are at making sense of the phenomenon.
The phenomenon is, no matter where you jump on Earth, you will land on the ground. You're going to use what you know and what you've learned about gravity to answer this question. What happens if you jump up in space? You're going to write your answer as the claim. Think of some evidence. We didn't talk about what happens in space. Do you think you could use the same evidence that we use to demonstrate gravity as evidence of what happens if you jump in space? Make sure that you write an explanation that shows how your evidence supports your claim.
Also, I'm going to have you go ahead into this vocabulary page and just fill in these three words to where they belong. And then I'm going to have you.
The last section, Show What You Know, has a chart that you're going to fill out about cause and effect. A ball tossed in the air. The question is, how does gravity affect the object? What evidence supports your claim? An example might be, gravity pulls the ball down. My evidence is, if I throw a ball in the air, it comes down. Now think about how gravity affects a meteorite that has come through the Earth's atmosphere. How does gravity affect the moon? Now it's your turn to log into Teach TCI. I want you to complete the wrap-up section. I want you to complete the making sense of phenomenon section, the vocabulary section, and the last section, show what you know.